and how are you all? I hope you all are fit and fine, and I hope you all are practicing for your exams also. You are practicing about new things what you are learning nowadays with the chapter 4, basic geometrical ideas. Okay, if you want to learn geometry nicely, you have to try to relate it with your surroundings, because see, geometry is all around us. Okay, you can find all the things, all the shapes, all the points what you have learned in the geometry some or another way. It is very much connected and very much there in our day-to-day life, regular life. So so far we have learned most of the shapes about in the geometry. Now today in our this video we are going to learn one more shape called circle. You all are very much familiar with the shape circle. You must be familiar with the parts of the circle. Okay, so let's learn about circle and parts of the circle. Okay, so let's learn about the parts of the circle. This is a circle. Always remember, when you start marking the parts of the circle, it's basically starts with the center point. This center point we can get when you draw a circle with your rounder, and this rounder can be called compass also, compasses also. So when you draw a circle with a rounder, you will get a small tiny dot in the between if you have drawn it with the proper way. Okay, so with the tiny dot which you are getting, that is called a center point, which comes exactly in the center of the circle, which comes exactly in the center of the circle, that is called center point. Always remember, here we are learning all the different parts of the circle. When you learn the different parts of circle, okay, all the parts should be named. Okay, so as you mark a new part of the circle, immediately you have to name it. Name how? Name it with a capital letter. As we know, the center point is it is a dot, and we all know how to name a point. Point is always named with a capital letter. So let's name the point O. Okay, what do we name it? Name O. Now I know this is a center point. How the third person know that this is the center point? So always remember that you have to mark each and every part of the circle. So here we'll put the arrow and we'll write center point, so that when the third person sees your circle, they can easily make out that this is something about the center point. And what is the center point name? The name of the center point is point O. Okay, so this is the name of the center point, point O. Okay, now the next portion comes of the part of the circle is called a diameter. Now diameter, see, in the very beginning of the chapter you have learned that about the point. That point is a basic building block of all the shapes, all the geometrical shapes. Okay, point is basic building block of all the geometrical shapes. So if I tell you that the circle is made up with the infinite points, because we all know all the figures in the geometry are made up with the infinite points. So in on this circle also infinite points are there, but as per our requirement we'll highlight the points and we name it. Okay, so our next part of the circle is diameter. Diameter, you all know that diameter is a line segment passing through the center point. See, I am each and every point will be discussing its definition also. All these definitions are given in your textbook. Okay, so you can say the diameter. Now, diameter is a line segment which is passing through the center point. Okay, so let's draw a line segment which is passing through the center point. Now, this line segment, when you talk about that it is passing through the center point, it does not mean that it can only pass vertically only. It can pass slant also, it can pass horizontal also. So if somebody asks you that with one center point in the circle, how many diameters you can draw? So here you can say we can draw infinite diameters on the circle, because if I say that how many lines or how many line segments can pass through a point, this question you must have come across in our previous exercises, that how many line or line segments can pass through the one point, and you must have written infinite. So here also I am talking about the one center point, and if I ask you that how many diameters can pass through one center point, the answer remains the same, that infinite. Okay, here I have drawn a diameter vertical. If you wish, you can draw a slant. If you wish, you can draw horizontal. But the condition is it should pass through the center point. Now, the diameter is a line segment with joining two points on the circle. Joining two points on the circle. When it is joining two points, here is a point and here is also a point. This point we have already named. Now, when you get two points, you have to name it. So let's name. See, you can, if nothing is specified in your question, you can give your own name. But if they have given you the name, this to the diameter, then you have to name it accordingly. Okay, so let's name it A and B. Okay, so now as we have name, mark and label, the center point, we'll have to label our diameter also. So this is a diameter. And what is the name of the diameter? Line segment AB. Line segment AB, because it is made up with the line segment, you have to name it as you name the line segment AB. You can also name it line segment BA. Anything you can give. Okay. So here we have two parts of the circle. Let's move to the third part of the circle, and very known part of the circle, that is called radius. Now, radius is again a line segment which starts from the center point and joining anywhere on the circle to any point. Okay, but the radius starts from the center point and it goes and joins on the circle somewhere to the point. Somewhere, anywhere. It is not necessary where. Okay, so here starting from the center point and joining a point on the circle called, this is called radius. Now, this radius is joined with the center point, so it is already, name is there. Here it is joining with another point which does not have name. So let's name it C. Let's name it C. Okay, so what is this? This is radius. And the name of the radius is CO. You can write CO, you can write OC, anything you can write. Now, if you observe, okay, let's again discuss the definition of the radius. Now, radius is a line segment. Radius is a line segment which joins a center point and a point on the circle. Okay, radius is a line segment which joins center point and a point on the circle. It's called a radius. Now, if you observe your diameter, just don't look at this image. Just observe from here to here. Can be a radius. So, can we say that half of the diameter, when you do the half of the diameter, we have radius. So can I say OB also a radius? Okay, if I hide this one, can I say OA is a radius? Yes, I can. Because when the two radius, the double of the radius becomes a one diameter, the same way, the half of the diameter becomes the radius. This you have already learnt in form 4 also, in form 5 also. Okay, so again, radius is a line segment which joins a center point and a point on the circle. Now the question comes that how many radius? Okay, when you are talking about one, it is called radius. But when you talk about a many, then it is called radii. What do we call radii? Plural of the radius, the plural of the radius called radii. Okay, so one radius can be called a radius, singular is a radius, plural is a radii. So here, so far, if you see, you can get three radii out of it. OA, OC, OB, they are the three radii easily you can get. Now, if I ask that how many radii can be drawn in a circle, so as you can draw infinite diameters in the circle, the same way, infinite radius also can be drawn on the circle, because there are infinite points are there on the circle. You can join any point with the center point and you get the radius. So infinite radius can be found on the circle. So far we have learned three parts: center point, diameter, radius, the plural of the radius called radii. Okay, now let's move to the next, is called chord. What is chord? Now chord is again a line segment, but this is such a line segment which is joining two points of the circle. Okay, two points of the circle. Then you say, madam, this diameter is also joining two points of the circle. Okay, so let's see a chord and then we'll relate the chord with the diameter. Okay, so here I'm highlighting two points and I'm joining it. Okay, I'm joining it here. Okay, as you highlight any two points, you don't forget to give the name. So let's name it P, Q. Okay, if they give you the name, then compulsory you have to give the same name, otherwise you can give your own name. Okay, so this is called chord. Okay, it's chord, it's not chord, it's chord. Okay, so now the name of the chord is line segment PQ. The name of the chord is line segment PQ. Okay, come to the main point. Now, chord is a line segment with joining two points on the circle. So, it is joining two points on the circle. This diameter also joining two points on the circle. So, do they have any relation, the diameter and a chord? Yes. Diameter can be called a longest chord because it is satisfying the property of chord. Chord is a line segment which joins two points on the circle. So, this diameter is also joining two points on the circle. Only the difference is, diameter is always passing through the center point, where the chord, all the chords are not passing through the center point. So, here you can say that, can we say that all the diameters are chord? Yes. You can say that all the diameters are chord because diameter is the longest chord. Okay, so all the diameters can be chord. But can I say that all the chords are diameters? No. All the chords are not diameter. I have drawn here. If you wish to draw here, you can draw it. If you wish to draw here, you can draw it. Only the thing is, it should satisfy the term that it should join the two points on the circle. So, chord is a line segment which joins two points on the circle. Okay, so this is chord. You all know when here it is a line segment, it should be named as how you are naming the line segment. I have written PQ. Somebody is like QP. It is okay. Okay. Now let's move to the next is arc. Okay. Let's move to the next is arc. So now when you talk about arc, arc is a portion of the circle. Okay. Now this is called circumference. If you highlight a portion of the circle, now this portion of the circle you can highlight anywhere. It is not necessary this portion, that portion. Okay, this also can be called arc, this also can be called arc, this also can be arc, this also can be arc. Arc is what? Arc is a portion of the circle. Arc is a portion of the circle. Okay, so let's highlight somewhere a little darken so that we can understand. Okay, this is called arc. Okay, so this is also can be called arc. Okay, we are highlighting it. You can highlight here also. You can highlight here also. You can highlight here also. Any portion. A portion means a small portion of the circle is called arc. And what is the shape of the arc? Okay, so this is
the circle is segment. Now, what is segment?
arc. This is also called arc. Okay, so what is the segment? When you shade it, okay, so this is the portion which is called a segment. Okay, this is called segment. Now, segment is the region, a shaded region covered by a chord and an arc. That is called segment. Let's name it. Now, make sure you draw a same kind of circle with this way, with all the parts done, with the heading part of the circle in your classwork. It's better when you watch the video. With the video, do one point, as we have started with the center point, then diameter, then radius, blah, okay, etc., etc. So, don't sit and try to draw all the parts together. Draw parts with the video one by one. It will become easy to understand also. Okay, generally students get confused between the sector and the segment. Make sure you understand the sector and the segment properly. What is sector? What is segment? Because when it is asked in the exam, the sector they draw segment, segment they draw sector. They shade correctly, but the name wrong. If this is the sector and if I name it segment, it becomes wrong. This is the segment and I name it sector, again it becomes wrong. Okay? So this is our circle, parts of the circle. With this we can again revise its interior, exterior, boundary. Okay, when you talk about the interior region of the circle, this is called the interior region of the circle, which is inside the circumference. This is circumference. Okay, whatever is inside the circumference, it's called the interior region. The circumference is called the boundary. And this is something which is outside, it's called the exterior. With that, you can also understand, when you talk about the diameter is the line segment which divides circle into two equal parts. And each part is called a semicircle. Okay, so diameter is a line segment which divides a circle into two equal parts, and each part is called semicircle. Okay, so with this we are completing our parts of circle. We will continue with exercise 4.6 in our next video. Till then, thank you, and please make sure that you do this in your classwork.